everybody has some good in them. And it was up to me to find that good.
Oh, that's good.
And I'm like, this is some pretty heavy.
That's an aha moment right there. Everybody got some good. You gotta find it sometimes. You gotta look real hard sometimes. You gotta look real hard. Hey, beautiful people with Success Mentor Dante Dankworth, and I'm back with another video right here on Audacious Believer TV! Now, if this is your first time tuning in, I need you to make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Make sure that you like this video. And make sure that you comment down below. Because my team and I absolutely love to read your comments. Now, tonight, we're being joined by the wonderful, the fabulous, the one, the only, tell them who you are, sir!
Right. Good evening. My name is Leslie Harvey, and I'm the Outreach Administrator for the Housing Council at Pathstone.
We invited Leslie on tonight to talk about putting humans back into the human services. Yes! Before we talk about that, we're going to ask you the question that we ask every single guest. What is your story?
Oh, my story, Dante. Yes. I am the son, the youngest son of a mom and father from the rural South.
Okay, hey, South.
I grew up in Florida, a little small town in the 60s era, so I'm dating myself. And my dad, who could not read and write, my mom had a seventh grade education, but my dad, certainly one of the smartest men that I've ever known.
Yes.
That's awesome.
So, but I got my first taste of working in the human services field when I worked for Wegmans, and Wegmans sent me on a special assignment with the Hillside Work Scholarship Program.
Yes.
And I just fell in love with the human services field.
Well, that's awesome. Shout out to the Hillside Work Scholarship Program. That's awesome.
Yes.
So when you think about putting humans back into the human services, what does that mean for you?
That means is that, you know, always going the extra step for folks. So many times when people come to us, Dante, they're certainly hurting. You know, in our particular field, they're looking for a place to live and find it very difficult, or they're having a landlord-tenant issue and they don't know what to do. So we're there to guide them. We just do so many wonderful things at the Housing Council, and I'm certainly very proud of the work that we do. So it's just a pleasure, and I think the greatest feeling I get is when somebody calls me and say, hey, you know, Mr. Leslie, I listened to what you said, I did this, I did that, and hey, the victory's mine.
That's good! That's good!
Beautiful thing.
I know when it comes to human services, there is a difference between sympathy and empathy. How can we empathize more in the human services field?
Wow. You know, I'd say this, Dante, that so many times when people come again and they're hurting, it's just a matter of putting yourself in their place, right? Really just trying to feel out, what can I do to really help this individual get past this hurdle in life? Because they might be having an issue right now, but somewhere down the road, you could be having an issue and you definitely want
that to hard. We're in the middle of a pandemic. Anybody can go through it.
So that is just so critical that you, like I like your title as put the human back into the human services field. This is important, man. People are hurting right now.
Yes.
So many ways, and we're there to really just help them through these difficult times.
Well, that's good. I know that in the human services field that there are people who are coming to you from all walks of life. How do you relate when you don't have that experience or you don't have that same story?
Well, you know, I look at it from this standpoint. With the work that I do, working and you know, on the outreach side of it, there are going to be things that, you know, I just don't know. So you always rely on your experts in that field. So if someone comes to me about buying a home for the first time and I don't really know all the ins and outs of it, I'm going to connect them with someone who simply does. They do this work day in and day out, and they're going to make it happen for them.
That's good. I know with any nonprofit, and we're getting federal funds or any funds, that they're usually outcomes. And it's very easy to lose sight that there's a human being that you have to deal with. And not just getting that outcome so you can keep that funding coming in. What are some ways that you stay focused on the outcomes while still humanizing who you're helping?
Well, once again, I always try to put myself in that individual's shoes. And to me, it's all about the individual. You know what I mean? We had a conversation here a couple of weeks ago, and there was somebody who had called me, and they were having some struggles. And this lady actually worked in the human services field. She worked at, I take that back, she worked at a hospital. And she was having some challenges. She said, just even putting food on the table, right? And that just pierced my heart. So I said to her, again, this is going way and above beyond the call of duty. I don't have to do these things. And in some cases, there's some things that we're not allowed to do. And I guess I'm somewhat of a rebel. So many times, you know, I know the rules say this, but if somebody is in need, I got to figure out a way to make it happen. Yes. So it was just a matter of going out that night. She sent me a list, and I went grocery shopping for her.
Oh, that's dope.
Out of my own pocket and stuff. And,
that's good. And, we appreciate that. That's awesome. That is awesome.
Yes, that's what it's all about.
Can you describe a time when you were in need and just were able to reach out to someone?
Yes, yes. I can tell you just about having a need for employment. When I first came here, and just so happened, I reached out to someone that worked at the organization. They told me what they had available. And I started 2 days later.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Asking for help.
Yeah. That's it. Right. Yes. So when somebody comes to me for help, I always reflect back on those times when I need it. So it's just a natural thing to do.
Yeah. But can you describe the best piece of advice you've ever received?
I would have to say, Dante, that came from my dad. I can think back many, many years ago. We were sitting down talking, and my dad said to me that he said, boy, he said, I want you to understand one thing.
Yeah.
He said that everybody has some good in them, and it was up to me to find that good.
Oh, that's good.
And I'm like, this is some pretty heavy.
That's an aha moment right there. Sometimes you gotta look real hard.
Yes. But you know, during times like these have been some very challenging times. I mean, we just saw what happened here at our nation's capital a couple of weeks ago, and but yet and still, you know, we have people who have all this hatred in their heart, and I would dare anyone who could come to me and say, hey, you know what? Leslie, I hate you. I dare them to get to know me. Because here's the thing, Dante, is that, believe it or not, we all really want some of the same things out of life.
Yes.
We want a good place to live.
Yes.
We want our children to have access to certainly be successful. And we want to be able to just do some basic things, right? Lead a good life. So if we sit down and talk to each other, this hatred could just dissipate.
That's good. Connection is awesome.
Yes.
Do you have a best friend?
Yes, I do.
Can you tell us how you two connected and how?
My best friend is one of my fraternity brothers.
Okay.
We went to school together. We pledged together. Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated.
Okay, you better shout out to them.
Yes. So, and they used to call us Pete and Repeat. We're about the same size. And in college, I probably was 135 pounds soaking wet. And I was a little bit bigger than him. So, but if anybody that's, you know, going through that process of certainly pleasant a fraternity, you know, it can be challenging. Especially during those times. But we were just always together. And even if I did something wrong, which I usually did. Being a rebel. You know, he was always there by my side.
Yes.
And still to this day, we keep in touch.
Oh,
he lives down in Atlanta, but you know, we're just going to call each other. Our sons are about the same age. Our sons are named after, you know, so my son's named after me, his son is named after him.
Yeah.
And it's just a beautiful thing that friendship has spanned over 40 years now.
Wow. 40 years. You know, they can't have Facebook for a lot of years. Be on a block list and everything. You got to go. That is awesome. Are you ready for rapid fire questions?
Yes, sir.
All right. Favorite book?
I would say, I've been, my sister had given me this book by T.D. Jakes, and really, as it talks about, you know, just living out your goals.
Yes.
And it's definitely just a good book, and just understanding your mission in life. And for me, there's so many good points in that book, because it's very critical, especially at this point in stage in my life, is that I just want to make sure that I'm able to really make a difference in the lives of people that are friends or folks that I come in contact with through work or what have you, certainly my family. And that's important to me.
T.D. Jakes is always right on that. I don't know. Favorite movie?
Favorite movie. I'd have to say, believe it or not, this is going back a while. I'm dating myself once again. Do the Right Thing.
Do the Right Thing. What do you see when you look in the mirror?
Well, I see a pretty handsome guy.
All right now. Come on now. What else you see?
No, I definitely see someone who's certainly very caring, someone who's passionate about life, certainly passionate about my family, and just someone who's always willing to dig a little bit deeper to really get to the root cause of some of the problems that we have, especially in our country today, and doing what I can do to just kind of wrong some of those rights, or right some of those wrongs, I should say.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Where do you find yourself most at peace?
When I'm home, you know, home is definitely just that place of refuge, where I can just sit, I can relax, you know, conversations with my wife and about, you know, simple things, you know, and I just love that time at home and what's quiet,
it's
peaceful. All those things that I carried from the day, I just kind of let them go.
Yeah, you're going to need some quiet after you up on my lap behind. And to be audacious means to be.
Just that, man, bold. Just willing to step out there.
Oh, that's good.
Yes, make things happen.
Yes!
Whatever it takes, make it happen.
Yes! Tell the people how they can find you online, how they can support you.
You can go to us. You can, if you have a problem or a question, a landlord-tenant issue, you want to buy a home for the first time, you have an issue with a possible foreclosure on your home, you can go to www.thehousingcouncil.org.
Yes.
And if you need to reach me directly, certainly go to lharvey@pathstone.org, or you can call us, 546-3700.
There you go, y'all! Until next time, remember that life is meant to be enjoyed and not just endured!